Hello there everyone, Ashnflash here, and welcome on into another video. Today we're going to be talking about all of these sets actually releasing in April. And there's actually quite a few different dates in April where different sets and things are actually releasing. So without further ado, let's go ahead and let's get started with tomorrow, April 1st. And I guess we'll start with the boring stuff that I didn't even know was releasing. But the second wave of the Friends Play Cubes are releasing, the ones with the random animals. And I don't know, I don't really have too much to say, but you've got Andrea's Shopping Play Cube, then you've got Emma's Shopping Play Cube, Maya's Shopping Play Cube, which is kind of interesting with like the movie theaters and the popcorn and all that. But then next up, we've got Olivia's Shopping Play Cube. And I gotta say, the only thing that when I was quickly looking at all these, I really like the chocolate fountain. That's a cool little design there for that. And then next up, we've got Stephanie's Shopping Play Cube, and all of these retailing for $9.99 USD each and $13.99 Canadian for each of them. And then next up, also tomorrow, which I'm going to be pre-ordering tonight at midnight, hopefully, because I feel like the site might crash with it, I'm not even kidding, it is the Pirates of Barracuda Bay, and that is the 30th LEGO Ideas set releasing, and I'm so excited about this set. It is so detailed. It is absolutely amazing. If you haven't seen the video, it's a crashed shipwreck, which also doubles as an inn, but you could take out the ship and actually create a pirate ship, the original one. It's been updated, and all the minifigures in this set are incredible. Specifically, the Redbeard figure is just absolutely amazing, and scattered throughout the entire set, there's a bunch of different references and cool little Easter eggs, so I can't wait to get this set in hand. It is absolutely amazing. Anyways, it is actually going to be releasing tomorrow, and the price for it is $199 USD and $259.99 Canadian. Again, get this while you can, because I think this is going to be one that sells out for sure. And then next up, the next set, it's not actually on LEGO Shop at Home, but it is technically a LEGO product releasing, and that is starting on April 7th. You can get your hands on the LEGO Star Wars Character Encyclopedia New Edition with the exclusive Darth Maul figure from Solo, a Star Wars Story. And minus the necklace, it's pretty much the exact same version of Maul that is in Clone Wars Season 7 coming up in an upcoming arc. So I'm so excited to get this minifigure. I actually already ordered this book because, you know, you're not going to be able to go out and get it when it actually does release in stores. So it'll just be coming whenever it does, because, yeah, it's everything's backlogged. So order it from like a bookstore or something. That's what I did. The estimated delivery for Amazon was like April 17th or something. But when I did it through Chapters, or I don't know what you guys call it in the US, but like it's Canada's Barnes and Nobles. Anyways, when I ordered it through them, it said that the shipping's only going to be 2 to 3 days, but it's probably going to be later. But just, you know, Amazon shipping out like literally anything, and Chapters is just books and different things, so it's going to arrive quicker with them. But anyways, the price for it is actually $17.99 USD and $25.99 Canadian. And again, that's releasing on April 7th. But moving on now, the next sets are actually also Star Wars related, and we've talked about them again in a separate video. Almost all this stuff you can hear in a more in-depth look, except for the Friends sets. But anyways, moving on now to the Star Wars sets. On April 19th, we actually have set number 75278, the Buildable Dio. And this is a Rise of Skywalker set, and like the other buildable droids and characters, this actually also comes with a minifigure scale of the character, so you also get a Dio, which is a cheaper alternative to the one that does come in the Millennium Falcon. And the set is going to be retailing for $69.99 USD or $89.99 Canadian. I'll be picking this up since I haven't missed a Rise of Skywalker set released yet. Anyways, moving on now, we've got 75277, Boba Fett's Helmet, and this is going to be releasing on April 19th, along with the other two busts, which we'll take a look at in a second. But the price for this is $59.99 USD and $79.99 Canadian. And I'm not sure if I'm going to be picking this one up. I do really like Boba Fett in general. I like the design and the red and all that, and I like the tile there. It's just I think it's really expensive, so I might only pick up one. I'm not too sure. We'll have to wait and see. I don't like that it's not the same style as the Darth Vader one that Justin was able to pick up for me, so I don't know. Might be a bit of a pass, but the next one is 75276, the Stormtrooper helmet, and it's the same price as the other one, and I really like it. I don't know. I like the idea. I like the designs. They're really detailed. It's just the price for this is just so much money. But moving on now to the TIE Fighter pilot, and I like the printed Imperial emblems and different things in the tubes. I really like the design for that and how the stand is a little bit different for this helmet. It's just, I don't really know. Again, price, it's a lot. It's a lot. And by the way, all three of these sets are actually marketed under the 40th anniversary of The Empire Strikes Back, so that's pretty special for these sets, and the boxes for them look really, really sleek. There's actually something else releasing on April 19th, I believe, and this is from reports. I've heard May 1st, but I've also seen, like, the actual card from the Toy Fairs. But the 20th LEGO minifigure series is supposed to be releasing on that day, and it is also the 10-year anniversary for that series. And I've done so many videos about it. I will link my latest one at the end and at the top if I remember to put the little card. But it's just a little disappointing for the 20th series. I'll have to wait until I get them in hand. And that's the other thing, is I'm not buying a box of 60 figures, so not sure when I'm gonna get this series, depending on when everything clears up, because there's no way I'm buying 60 figures, especially for this series. And then next up, on April 27th, we have two sets, and unfortunately, that was when the Minions line was going to be debuting, but because the movie has been pushed back, I think that they've pulled a couple of these sets that were supposed to release for Minions off the shelves, and they're going to be delaying them and releasing them a little closer too, but it's interesting that they still are releasing these two sets. Anyways, those two sets are set number 75549, the Unstoppable Bike Chase, and it is going to be retailing for $19.99 USD and $24.99 Canadian. And this is the only set in the entire wave to come with an actual minifigure, and it is actually Gru, so he looks really awesome there. I don't like that he is using regular legs. I'll probably sub them out for short legs, but I really love the designs for the Minions and everything that they've created for them. I love the feet, as well as, I don't know if the arms are separate or not, we'll have to wait and see, but the head there is really cool, and I like the little studs with the eyes. I think that that's such a cool and unique addition. And just the set, I like the bike. It's an interesting sort of build, and you can put Gru and the Minions and different things in different sections, so I think it's a really fun set. For the price, it's pretty good. And then next up, we've got set number 75551, and it is the brick-built Minions and their lair. And this is going to be retailing for $49.99 USD and $69.99 Canadian. And I really love this. I think that it's so, so cool. I love the design of the brick-built Minions. They look really, really awesome there. And what's really interesting to me, I really like that you can build Stuart and Kevin, but not just that, you can also transform Kevin into Bob, which is just something really, really cool. I love the way that that looks with the two eyes. It's just so adorable, and I like that idea. It almost makes me want to go out and get two so that I can have all three of the main Minions from the movies. But anyways, the actual interior of them look really, really awesome. I love how the inside actually has this personalized version for like Kevin, and he's just got all these cool tiles and different things. I love the designs and all that. It looks super, super cool. And then of course, next up, we've got Stuart, and he's got a really cool looking area as well with all these different prints. Again, I think they're stickers, but they still look really, really awesome. And then Bob has this other design. So I'm so confused by this set. I'm not understanding. It says rebuild Kevin into Bob, but the insides look so different. Like, wow, that's crazy how much you're going to have to change to rebuild it to Bob. Now I might actually get two on the day that this comes out, because now that they're actually personalized on the inside as well, completely differently, that's so intriguing. That's really, really awesome and unique to this set. Although I wish that it did actually just come with all three of them, but anyways, I could talk about that more and more. But lastly, if you didn't know, I actually have two things in my contract with Justin when it comes to making CMF series. Number one is I never have to do another Fortnite CMF series, and number two is I will never do a Fast and Furious series. Thankfully, the movie got delayed, and I'll have to put on next year's contract as well, but Dom's Dodge Charger has been revealed literally yesterday, I think it was, for Technic, and this is a crossover tie-in or something with Fast and Furious, and it's interesting that this is still releasing even though the movie has been pushed back to 2021. I'm not a fan of these movies, and I'm not a fan of cars either, so yeah, anyways, here's the info. It's $99.99 USD, and in Canada, it's $139.99 Canadian. This will be releasing on April 27th, along with the two Minion sets. But anyways, everyone, what do you think of all the sets releasing in April? What are you planning on picking up? If you've already ordered stuff, pre-ordered different things, let me know. I think that you can pre-order the car for Technic. And that's about it right now for all the April sets. But of course, there's also the book that you can pre-order. But don't be afraid of like the virus and different things. If you just gotta be cautious when you're actually receiving the packages. Like I've been getting some stuff because I'm working on a separate video on the extra channel that I'm gonna be uploading hopefully soon. And I've been getting packages and you just need to be mindful of what you do with them. Just open them and then clean like the box or whatever that you get on the inside the Lego set box. That's what I'm going to be doing with all these things when they do wind up ordering, because it looks like we're going to be stuck inside for a bit longer. But anyways, everyone, I hope that you did enjoy the video. Again, let me know down below in the comment section what you think of all this stuff. I hope that you did enjoy it, and I hope that you all have a great day. Be sure to stay safe and healthy. I'll see you all in the next one.